Let's create a cylinder. Tab to go to edit mode, and 3 to face selection mode. Let's select the top face, and type G and Z to move it downward like this. E to extrude, and enter to settle. S to scale, and E to extrude upward. Again, E, and enter. S and E to create a scaled extrude mesh like this. Let's Alt select this face loop, and S to scale. We can select this edge loop, and type G and Z to bring it down. Let's create 6 loop cuts. We can Shift, Alt select multiple edge loops, and Alt E to extrude along normals. Control 3 to subdivide. Let's use Control R to add some loop cuts to make certain edges sharper. Let's select the face in the middle, and type I as in India to extrude inward twice. Time to add a material. We need an emission shader for this face. If we see that shape in the middle, that means we need to extrude inward once more. Let's switch the render engine to Eevee, and activate the bloom setting. This is how we create the glow effect in Eevee. Shift D to duplicate. Let's set up the render scene. If we switch the render engine to cycles, then the glow effect won't work anymore. Let's go to the compositing tab. Please watch a tutorial listed in the description to match my final render settings, as I'm using a cloned Look Dev HDRI setting. The current composite nodes were arranged to apply the denoise feature, and this is only for the cycles. For Eevee, we need to uncheck the Use Nodes option at the top, otherwise the renderer will create a blank render image. To have the glow effect, we need to press Shift A to create a glare node. We need then select the fog glow feature, and set it as high. We will only be able to see the glow effect after Blender completes the rendering process. This is before, and this is after. This is Eevee with the bloom setting turned on. This is the end of the tutorial. Please like and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. Thank you for watching.